Hi, everybody. This is Stephen Brody Stevens. You are tuned in to the Brode and Esther Show, number 5, possibly. I am your person speaking first, Stephen Brody Stevens, a.k.a. SBS. And I am here with Esther. I can't pronounce her last name yet. I have a stumbling block. So
you can try.
Potitsky.
No.
Povitsky. Okay, so I can't.
It's pretty easy. Povitsky.
I just psyched myself out.
Yeah.
And of course, we have Brian, a.k.a. Red Band.
Hello.
He's very involved. Several shows on the network. The numbers are going up. iTunes is taking notice. Stitcher is getting their act together. My name is Brody, born in the Valley. I'm thinking about you at home, the listener, you in your car, the driver, you as a kid in a room. You know, I'm your wrestling. I'm your Benny Hill. I'm your Beavis and Butthead. But why would I even put myself in that that family?
How
dare me? How dare me? So it's been a little while.
Yeah.
People have been asking, where has the Brode and Esther show gone? It's scheduling. We have our own life issues. We'll do a pop in like we did the other night. That was what, a week ago? About
that didn't ever make it to air though, did it?
The one that we did like at 2 a.m.
Well, my mom was
When Esther's mom was here.
Oh, no, we didn't do that because there was too many things that we had to edit out.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like what had to be edited out of a podcast like that?
Yeah, there was just things like...
Just little things.
People's names were used that shouldn't have been used, and things that we discussed about shouldn't have been discussed.
Was I a part of it?
No.
Well, I don't remember it.
No.
I honestly don't remember.
So your mom's stuff, but I was here for all her stuff, wasn't I, or no?
Yeah,
I may have not.
Oh, no, you guys left, and then it was just me and my mom, and it was like...
And you wanted that cut out.
Oh, no, I didn't care about it.
There was things that I had with somebody else, and there was like all these people were like, well, can you please edit this out? Can you please? So then it was like, all right, that was too sloppy. I'm not going to sit there and spend like 3 hours trying to find everything to edit. So
I'm just curious who was complaining, if they were, who was... was it anything I did?
No,
it wasn't
anything
you did.
No.
I'm not saying at fault, but I want to know, okay, if I'm not at fault, was I in the middle of it somehow? Did it happen around me?
No. I don't know. Maybe.
Because on my, I felt like it was a pretty, when I was here in the room, the secret podcast studio, I felt that things I was, the other people I was involved, that they were going well.
Yeah,
it
did go well. There was like little...
Little slip-ups, and I guess it'd be easier to say...
I understand.
Yeah.
And I appreciate that. You know what? It's better to be safe than sorry. You don't want to put that stuff out there. So let's give Brian a nice hand, Red Band, for doing that. That's very good.
And maybe one day in the future, when like I'm sick in bed with the flu or something, I'll go through it and try to edit it.
I would like to hear them part with me and my mom. That was
yeah, I thought it was cool meeting your mom. It was also weird, just like when she was on, I was on stage, I was like trying to talk to her because I felt bad for you because of the buildup that you gave about your mom coming.
I felt
like you were almost like a beaten child.
I was really
whoa,
scared.
Whoa, let's keep it positive. We do not, there's just no reason to put that.
All right, I felt like you were Penn Stated before.
That's even worse, Brian. I can't be involved with this kind of stuff.
No, I agree, Brian.
My agents won't let me be allowed in this kind of environment.
And
we have to keep it positive. Go ahead,
let
Esther.
Me. No, yeah, no. I was really nervous for my mom to come visit me because I knew that she was going to see my messy apartment.
Messy's better than dirty. But go
true,
ahead.
True, but it was also dirty underneath. Ooh. And my horribly filthy car. And she saw it, and she like I thought was very, very, very pissed off.
Why didn't you get your car cleaned before your mom arrived?
I don't know. It's like I had all this anxiety about it, and I just didn't want to do it.
But why didn't you just tackle it? Just, you know your mom is coming. I mean, that's a real...
That's what I was like, I'm going to go take it. I'm going to get it detailed. And then like 3 big things came up that week.
What were those 3 big things?
Like just like meetings that I had to like...
Okay, meetings are important.
Right. And that's what I feel like. I always intend to clean, and then like something comes up, and I put it off. But my mom came in town and cleaned everything.
So. Well, that's nice. Well, that's what moms are for.
Yeah.
To do that sort of thing.
Yes.
But it probably helps to be in a clean environment. Less clutter.
It does help. I've been a lot happier.
Is good for you, and also, I'm closer to the mic. Less clutter is good for you, and it's just healthy to be around a clean environment.
Yeah. You guys met my mom. What did you think?
She was great. What's her name? Kim?
Mary.
Okay, Mary.
I thought she was cute.
So, Esther.
You guys are closer in age.
I know.
Than me and you are.
I know, that's weird.
So, Esther, as you can see, I didn't have to, but I cut my hair. I got a haircut down in Palm Springs. Palm Desert, actually. And it could have done a... He did fine, but I feel like because I'm on the medication, this court, L.A. County court, I'm just doing what the doctors tell me to do.
I tell you, I think you should flush your medication.
No, I can't. No, you can't do that.
You can't do that.
You can't do that, Esther.
I did.
That's what got me in trouble. I stopped taking Lexapro because I got sick in Montreal. We all know that. Get that story out there that I stopped taking Lexapro because I picked up basically 24-hour flu that turned into strep throat. And then I went on antibiotics, and I said, my physical health means more than my mental health. And I just focused on getting physically better. And while I was getting physically better, I've been off. Everybody's not has missed a day or two of Lexapro. It's that you're not going to become a monster. And I just happen to have good shows. And it's like, wow, I'm feeling good, and I'm having good shows. So and then just a couple good things happened, and people just thought I was a little out of my they may have been right. They may have been right because you're not supposed to stop taking Lexapro or any of those drugs cold turkey. You can't do it. Let me be an example.
Yeah.
Let me be an example.
I guess I went off birth control, and that wasn't that big of a deal. But it did change me.
But I was getting laughs. People enjoy. That's the other thing. I was getting laughs. People were hashtagging me. People were quoting me. And then I was responding to texts and phone calls and conversations, and people couldn't see that on Twitter. I mentioned I had a gun on Twitter as a joke, back off. And that just freaked people out. And I guess looking back on it, as I practice this, and I say this every podcast I do, I just got to do it because it sucks. They put me on these freaking meds, and they make me a zombie. That's the thing. If you're on medication, usually you go through you'll go through the side effect periods. But this thing that they got me on, not only do I have side effects, I'm still sleeping all day.
Yeah, that's how I was on the birth control, but that's like a way different medicine. I literally couldn't get out of bed and couldn't stop eating.
Birth control did that to you?
Yeah, I mean, but I never do drugs or any medicine, so like it really affected me. And it made my boobs like two sizes bigger. They're down now. I went off.
So birth control, is that a common side effect, being tired, sleepy?
I think so.
No, yes. I've never heard that in my whole entire life. I think birth control makes your moods change, your personality change, because it fucks with your hormones and stuff like that. But
it makes you think you're pregnant. And I think I talked about this last time.
Yeah.
Like it made me go to Target and buy like baby stuff.
Why?
Because it like makes you
baby
like,
food, you do eat that.
I know, and that's from I started that on the birth control. Like, because I bought it all and I didn't know what to do with it.
Are you saying birth control is this as potent as Lexapro
for
or
me,
Celexa?
For me, I think.
Did you start painting your walls yellow and you're like preparing for a baby?
A neutral baby. I kind of did. I like became maternal and like I wanted a baby.
Yeah, you did.
I did want a baby. But then I went off it and was like, ew, kill babies.
Kill babies.
Not really.
You don't want to do that. I'm still thinking about like, you know, I'm thinking about me. I'm being selfish right now. I'm thinking about me. And I can't do that.
You should try birth control and see if it's a...
There you go. They have male birth control out there.
No, do they really?
Yeah.
What? Are you serious?
I don't know. I'm just saying maybe they do. So what about exercise? I'm getting back into it because my levels of Depakote have been lowered. So once I get up, I'm up. It's like coming out of that dark, deep sleep. And it's hard to get going. You're groggy. And I can't...
Yeah.
And it's hard to keep up with reading scripts, returning phone calls, getting a good solid workout in, whatever it may be, and I gotta just go through it. And so I feel like I'm in Hollywood, I'm in show business with, you know, one hand tied behind my back, basically.
Yeah, right, I mean now. I know how you feel because that's exactly how I felt when I was on the pill, and it's like I gotta push through it, and I just couldn't. And as soon as I went off it, it was like.
Do people talk about being on or off birth control? Is that common, or is that ladylike, unladylike? Is that comedic? Is it weird? Because I'm talking the Lexapro because, you know, it's a man and a woman can take it. You can split it. A family can split a Lexapro. You know, a couple. So, are you open about it? Do you get pushback on talking about?
No, I think a lot of people. I think a lot of people. It's not because it's not even to be. I wasn't even on it for birth control reasons. It was.
What were you on it for?
It cleared my face up. It made my face amazing.
Like is that common?
Yeah,
that is a side effect of birth control.
Yeah, because
for some, definitely.
The hormones in birth control like make your body think it's pregnant, and like pregnant women always have really good skin, and
Is that what Proactiv does?
Proactiv is like weird. Proactiv like cleared my skin up, but then like I would have one big pimple.
So you did use it?
I used Proactiv like a year ago.
I bought actually a case of Proactiv in Las Vegas.
I have an extra case if anyone wants it.
Does it work? I mean, is it just basic stuff or is it?
I think it's too much chemicals. It's like icky.
You know, the best thing, the best medicine for skin is just not eating sweets.
Whoa. Take it back.
No, I think a lot of your skin ailments are from
their diet related.
Stress, diet, that sort of thing. Sweating, maybe. You're starting to work out a little bit.
Well,
you're sweating more.
I noticed my skin got a little bad when I went off it, but I just now that I'm not on the birth control pill, I need to like really focus on how I'm eating to like keep my skin nice.
And you can do that.
Yeah.
You can do that. You eat good foods. I heard you did. I'm trying to eat more bananas. I'm trying to eat more apples.
I'm not a banana fan.
Why not?
Bananas are really high in sugar.
They are?
Yeah.
Okay.
Apples are great. They're an appetite suppressant. They have a lot of nutrients.
Is it true they say an apple a day keeps the doctor away? Is there some truth to that?
I think so, Brian.
Brian, want to answer on the apple?
Apple a day?
I have no idea.
Okay. I think if there's got to be something. I mean, yeah.
Apples have to be good for you.
Yeah.
Because when I was at the UCLA psych ward for 17 days against my will, I ate apples and bananas every day.
Really?
I ate apples, bananas, and every day, sandwiches, and the regular meal. And I got down to 187 pounds. Now I'm back up to 220 probably.
But the reason that you're up is because the medication you're on is making you eat more.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. I would be.
And it's impossible to fight that you're
fighting
nature.
Well, I'm gonna. What do you mean it's not? What do you mean it's impossible to fight?
It's just really hard. I tried for a long time to fight the urge that medicine made me have, and I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it.
Okay, I have to do it. There's no couldn't. I have to do it. I have an opportunity in January to be on national television, and I have to feel good about myself. It's not actually looking good. It's feeling good. And that's what I need to do. And the help of bananas and apples, lowering my Depakote, lowering the Seroquel, getting Brody. Steven,
salads
Brody,
are more important.
Stevens. I eat salads. I'll eat an ice wedge. I'll eat a...
That's not good.
Why is that bad? Iceberg lettuce is bad?
Iceberg lettuce has no nutrients.
Has no nutrients.
But it's better than nothing.
It is, but like it's not...
Barely.
I mean, it's
but you
like,
know what?
Romaine.
It takes a
kale,
while to eat.
Spinach.
My mom got one. I got one. We shared. I thought it was a fun exercise.
Yeah, if you're getting salads, always stay away from the iceberg because there's like literally there's nothing in
it. I've heard that. But does it act as a appetite suppressant? Does it coat the stomach for the entree? These are things I want to know about the iceberg
wedge. Yes, it fills you up, but the dressing or whatever the fuck is on it. Excuse me.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
What are you hanging out with? These alley rats?
Alley cats?
Who am I?
What about Caesar salad? Caesar dressing's got to be fattening.
It's fattening, but...
Okay.
You can't.
But I hear you, Brian, you know, you said like Joe Rogan eats whatever he wants. This guy's constantly working out. He's constantly feeding that machine.
He's not thin.
Oh, taking a shot at Joe Rogan. Esther.
No, he has a good body, but he's not super thin. He eats. But he's doing that thing that we talked about, the Kimberly Snyder diet, right?
That's what? Putting all that stuff into a blender?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's doing a lot of blending.
I like that.
I am too. I'm doing Vitamix. I had a juicer at first, but then the more I got into juicing, I did research and found that juicing is actually not that good. It's because you're not getting any of the fiber. So you're getting all this juice and all the sugars. So if you're using a lot of like fruits and stuff like that, you're getting so much sugar and no fiber at all. So the blender uses you're doing everything. So you're getting more fiber and it's way more healthier.
Juicing is okay.
Like if you juice carrots, which I like juicing carrots. If you juice too much carrots, since there's no fiber, it attaches to something else in your skin and your actual skin will start turning orange.
Oh.
Snooki.
Like somebody
tanning.
Snooki
Pavitsky.
Yeah, she does it. So, but these, I have a blender.
You can do?
Yeah, I have a blender at home. I certainly
do. Spinach blends really easily. I would do like...
So you actually put spinach, frozen spinach in it?
No, fresh, organic.
So go to Rock and Roll Ralph's, grab some stuff.
Ralph's.
Go to Rock and Roll Whole Foods.
Yeah.
Go to Slow Rock Whole Foods and grab some of all that stuff. You know what? Here's the deal. The apartment that we live in the same neighborhood, yes. Actually the same building.
Yesterday I was sitting in my car and there was a knock on the windshield and I got really scared.
Well, I thought you saw me. I stood there for a while.
Really? I was on the phone.
Really got scared? I didn't want to scare you.
No, I wasn't scared. I was like, who's knocking on my thing? But then it was you and I was like, oh, it's Brody.
Well, I stood there before I knocked.
Did you hear me talking on the phone?
I could tell you were on the phone.
Oh.
By the way, I had duplicate keys made. Can I give them to you?
Yeah, totally.
I'm going to give you keys, and you can give me your keys.
I will, yeah.
And I'll protect you. I will protect your studio apartment when you go out and book something and have to go away for 3 days on location.
Thank
you're
you.
Doing things. The Fox show, the commercials, the tweeting, going over 10,000 followers. Etzger, Potsvitsky. Did I say it right? No, we got to do it again. So it is about positivity. My hair, I had to shave it, kind of. That's the other thing. You know, I don't want my whole life and all my comedy shows to be about me being on medication. But this stuff is rough. And I didn't do anything wrong. They're going to make me apologize. I don't want...
Who's going to make you apologize?
I have to apologize to people that I was mean to. That's what I'm hearing. I'm just telling you, I have to really stress, like, I think it's just me. I got physically sick. That's what happens.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it wasn't anything else. I mean, maybe when I was at Chelsea, I was the audience warm up at Chelsea lately, 400 shows. And I remember on one of these holiday, we had to do two shows and we did it on a holiday. Chelsea Handler was always fine to me. No issues there. She was hosting the MTV Video Music Awards. So we had to do all these extra shows because she wasn't going to be around as much for the next coming weeks. So we're doing a show and it feels like a holiday. No one's in the office. No one's around the complex there. Why are you laughing, Esther? Why are you guys laughing? I'm going to stop this.
No.
This is a very important story.
We all know it.
What do you know?
This is the story about how they were mistreated you and then they...
But here's my feeling. There are new listeners to the podcast all the time.
True.
So this is for the new guy. This is for me preparing my story if I ever go on a talk show. That's my theory behind stuff. You practice it. But I felt like the energy would it disappeared. It kind of left me hanging. I'm going through a rough time. How would you feel if that was a regular gig, regular income?
Yeah.
And you put your heart and soul into something and you felt like it didn't have to end that way. It could have still been going. It could have been tapered down like Depakote and Seroquel. But it came to an abrupt stop and there was weight thrown around. And I'm just about the show. I'm about the show.
Right.
I'm about the job. Never been arrested. Never been to jail. You know, people are harsh on me. I'm too nice of a guy. I was taken advantage of. I am a nice person. Too nice. I try to please everybody. What's so funny? Have I said
You're
this
You're giving
before?
Me the giggles. I can't. I don't know.
Why are you giggling, Esther?
Because it's funny.
That I have issues?
No. That's not funny.
I don't have issues. My issues aren't any worse than anybody else's.
I don't
else's.
Think you have... Everyone else thinks you have issues. I actually...
Oh, they do? Who? Give me names. Give
everyone
me
that you say,
names.
I don't think you have issues.
No.
And I don't think you're crazy at all. I think that actually... Like, I can see where you're coming from at all points. Like, that's probably maybe because maybe I'm crazy too, but, I get what you're... Like, I get everything.
Yeah, it was like, I'm just playing the hand that was dealt me. I'm not, you know, my childhood, my teen years, my college baseball years, my early comedy years, I didn't get treated any worse than anybody else, but I was so diverse in what I did. I got it from everywhere. The athletes went after me. The smart comedy kids went after me. The cool kids. I went to Reseda. I drove a Pinto. I have low self-esteem.
I do, too.
About certain things. You know, I wish I... You know, I'm a good baseball player, but I don't look like it. I mean, I kind of look like a baseball player, but how I run, I'm kind of goofy. That bothers me. They go, oh, what are you, gay? You walk like... And I'm not. I'm not. I'm into chicks. But these guys, myself, I'm too sensitive, and they think that being sensitive is a thing of being gay. No, it's not. It's
Do you,
not.
It's not. No, it's definitely not. My dad likes musicals.
That's gay.
I like the taste of penis.
Hey.
I mean, I used the P word.
My wait, but what was I going to say to you, Brody?
You know, I like I said, I didn't go through anything, but I didn't have, you know, this is a result of having your parents divorce, and I'm not blaming my mom or dad, but there's a reason why, you know, having a male figure around, like a father, it helps, or an older brother, it helps. I didn't have that, so I was around a mom who worried. I was around a sister who was kind of tough on me, not in a good way, and my dad did what he could do. Both of my dads, Jack, my mom's second husband or third husband, whatever it was, and then my dad, they did what they can do. But still, I was too sensitive. That's something that maybe I was just like, that could be treated with medication, therapy. I'm just a nice guy.
I don't think there's wrong with that, though. I think being too sensitive, I think I'm the same way. I also grew up with my mom and my sister. My dad, I saw every couple weekends, but he's not the one that pretty much raised me. And I find myself overly sensitive and stuff, but I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I don't think you should take medication for sensitivity.
I'm the opposite. My dad was like the main person around. And that's,
oh, really?
That's why I'm kind of manly, I think.
And here's the deal. I get that, and then sometimes I get into my head, and I go, then it's like a, you know, self-fulfilling prophecy. Is that what they call it?
Yeah.
That's what I don't want to happen when I get back to normal. I don't want everyone putting their worries on me, because that's kind of what happened. They were putting it on me, you know, and I don't want that to happen again. But I'll be better prepared, better support system. By me talking about it, like doing these therapy sessions for this podcast, it's helping me, as I knock out my thing again. It's helping me. You help me. I help you. Go on my Wikipedia page. Check in
you
on Brody.
You have a Wikipedia page?
Somebody put it up. Why'd you say it like that?
Because I've been trying to get a Wikipedia page for so long. So that's positive right there that you have a Wikipedia page.
Somebody said I do.
It's really hard to get one.
Brody, I have a question. Yeah. You said you're into chicks. I have a question. Do you, when you do your shows, do you have like groupie girls? Or
no.
Like, do you have like open mic girls or girls on the comedy scene that like try to get it?
Occasionally, I would say like a new young comedian to town might take an interest in me. Possibly a female. It could happen. I have seen maybe other female comedians established, put out certain kind of energies, possibly. But for me, it's still kind of weird. I'm not weird, but I'm not totally into dating a funny girl. I'm not into it. I'm kind of into...
What's your dream girl?
Well, I don't have a dream
girl.
What in your head is your dream girl? Is it like...
Clean and pure. So, German, blonde.
German?
That's the other thing. That's the other thing. That I think that's not... That doesn't help me. Yeah, your mom was cute. This is another thing. Because I'm Jewish and I wasn't bar mitzvahed, I was blue-collar Jewish, raised in the valley, went to Reseda High School, drove a Pinto. It wasn't like I was on the west side or I was in Encino. I didn't have that. I don't have that backing behind me. So that's why I feel like everything I do, it's going to be a long road because I didn't take the time to do the bar mitzvah. I didn't take the time to figure out the 9 days of Hanukkah. I'm more into like a people person. I like you. I hang out with you. We laugh. I am a guy. I'm not necessarily into buying gifts. And that might just be, you know, I should be. But is it because I don't have money or I don't have the time or I'm not in yet? You know, I feel like when you're an American, when you can relax, if you want to call that, it's like house, you know, own property, married with a child.
Yeah, that's like...
And I have your own car.
But a lot of guys that I meet are like, it seems like no guy wants to date like another comedian, but like it's just we're there. It's like I feel like maybe you could date someone that's in comedy.
I've done it before. I've done it. I've been with a couple, I'm sure, that have actually taken the stage. Yes. I've been with those on the exterior of the business, maybe somebody involved on the other side, like a manager or an agent.
Oh,
maybe
I like that.
Maybe a waitress here and there. But I feel like because I am scratching and clawing, and I'm not saying that you're always going to be scratching and clawing, but I guarantee you there's plenty of people in the comedy business that didn't have to. They just kind of stayed in their lane, did their thing. They went to Temple. They looked a certain way. They hung out with a certain people. They wrote a couple jokes. They got on TV. They did all the right things because they're smart. They get it. I'm not. I'm not that smart. 2.52 from Arizona State GPA.
It smells like smoke, Brian. What's this?
Yeah, it's very smoky in here.
I think my grandma.
I think that there's nothing wrong with dating a fellow comic, but I think the reason that it sucks so much is that comedy is usually based on telling like relationship jokes.
Yep.
So when you break up,
you're right.
Not only are you seeing your ex everywhere you go.
Yeah, that's I've dealt with that.
It's like fucking somebody at work. You're not supposed to.
It's like being on a cruise ship. Yeah. Doing comedy on a cruise ship. Yeah. You're stuck with them for 5 days. And I've never done that. But I've done audience warm-up. I'm great at doing 3 hours worth of, up to 3 hours work, maybe four, possibly five. Up, I would say four would be my limit. Three would be a nice, I can do it. 3 years audience warm-up, I've done that. I've done the hosting. I've done closing a show, one of these alternative B rooms where I'll be downtown tonight. Bottom line is that you got to put out positive energy. You got to eat well. You got to smile. Where were we yesterday? You're talking about your mom, your birth control.
Dating.
Yeah.
Do you get bed bugs? Sorry.
No. Bed bugs? I don't even know what a bed bug is.
You got bed bugs?
And where does that come from?
I don't know, but I've been.
Poor hygiene. I was being serious.
I was wondering if like this is an isolated incident for me, but like I've been itching a lot in bed.
That could be nerves.
No, well, there's actual bites.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
And what floor are you on?
Two.
So they can climb down to my floor. That's scary. There could be bed bugs in my building. In fact, yesterday I get a knock on the door at 11 a.m. It's our manager, Tony, and he goes, do you have anybody staying with you? I go, no. And he goes, I think we have somebody trying to climb in the windows that say they're staying with somebody.
What?
I go, thanks. It's 11 a.m. Don't knock on my door ever again at this time. 12, possibly. 11, no. I can't wait to get back to being myself again in terms of...
You have to get off these medications.
Well, you stop being... Esther.
What?
You're saying it like I shouldn't be taking them.
I don't think you should.
But I have to take them. Hollywood's making me. I have to. Do you understand? Now I'm finally playing the game.
I believe in you, and I believe that if you woke up every morning and ran and did your thing... And
I don't run in public. People laugh at me.
If you exercised and
which
ate
I'm doing.
Right...
Which
you
I'm could, trying to
I
do.
I think you could be off the medicine.
Okay, well, that's...
That's my own philosophy, and it's probably wrong.
But Esther, you're not wrong. I'm going to tell you. You just can't stop cold turkey. You can't.
Right.
I had to do what I had to do. And then once the doctor assesses, he's been assessing the situation, he's been tapering me down. I'm almost
like...
down to a half of what I was on at my most... at my highest level. I'm down to half.
I feel like I'm Tom Cruise and Brody is Brooke Shields.
Esther, obviously there's definitely situations where medication's probably not the best. You know, like there's definitely situations where like there's somebody that's depressed and they've been put on a drug for a lot of their life and now they don't know what it is. You know, everyone gets depressed.
Maybe it's because I'm depressed, I'm bipolar, I've got problems and I've never been on medicine.
But you do comedy, you have that great outlet.
Yeah.
You do auditioning, driving around to the audition, signing up. No, I don't. That's negative.
But maybe
that's negative, driving around to an audition. No, Esther, this is what I'm saying. We agree on the same thing. I'm just saying right now, me, Stephen Brody Stevens, where we are at, I need to take these because I'm working with the doctor.
Right.
I don't get that second chance because I stopped taking Lexapro in Montreal, and look what happened. I hit a freaking grand slam, and the guys... tackled me, and I didn't get to touch home plate. That's what happened.
Yeah.
Let's learn about this bed bug thing a little. Because did you know, where this is what I've always heard, is that bed bugs, like, if you have a mattress that's certain amount of, like, age, that it's filled with bugs.
Okay,
yeah,
gross.
Probably after 8 years.
Actually, no, this mattress is new. I bought it when I moved to L.A.
So how long have you been here? 3 years?
Almost.
It's fine.
Because now they're back. And you've got a lot of questions about them. We've assembled a panel of our best experts here at The Early Show to answer all of your bed bug questions. You've been calling them in, emailing,
off.
Facebook, Twitter, you name it. People in the crowd, you have questions. We're going to answer them this morning. To help us do that, CBS News Business and Economics correspondent Rebecca Jarvis, medical correspondent Dr. Jennifer Ashton, and also our veterinary correspondent, among a few other talents, Dr. Debbie Turner-Bell. So, first question that we're getting, I want to direct to you, Jen, which came to us via Twitter.
Let's ask
a viewer tweets.
Here's a question about bed bugs.
How do I know? How is it different looking from a mosquito bite? Basically, how do you know that it's a bed bug bite?
Very good question, and very hard one to answer because it can be very difficult to distinguish a bed bug from a mosquito bite. Let's say from a pimple. Even dermatologists can have a hard time. But there are a couple of little generalizations that you can tend to look for. Number one, a bed bug doesn't tend to give that swelling and pink.
Gross.
Diffuse ring around the bite like a mosquito bite does when it gets swollen and starts to itch right away. Here. There may be a little scab in the middle of a bed bug bite where you don't
graphic. You should have warned the audience.
Types of bites, especially mosquito bites. And
I don't look like that.
So for the people listening, what it looks like a mosquito bite is like puffy. It almost looks like a mosquito bite. Where this looks more like a rash.
I only have two or three of them, and
let me see. Let's see what it looks like.
Oh, I have to pee. Okay. You can't see from here.
What? Wait, Esther, you have to use a restroom? What's so funny? Keep it. Let the crowds at home laugh. Let the truck driver laugh.
You're right.
We are professional.
You're right.
No, laughing's good. I need to laugh more. I don't laugh enough.
Yeah, you do. Need to laugh more.
But, you know, it's... So you're saying I don't have to shave my head. It's fine.
No, your hair looks good.
But my hairline, that's another side effect, losing hair. So
really?
I feel like, I had a ton of hair anyway, but it's like going quick now. So I shaved it last night. You're saying it doesn't look weird. I'm going to give you a crown shot.
No, I think it looks normal.
No, it looks
normal. I would not look at that and be like, oh, that looks weird.
So some guys do that. That's called like shaving your hairline, right? Kind of? That's what they do?
I guess. Yeah.
You don't think it's...
I don't know guys that shave their... head personally.
Why?
The only guy I know is my dad.
But shaving heads is acceptable style, right, Brian?
Yeah, it's
yeah.
I've done it before.
It's a buzz cut.
I personally like it a little like how it is right now. I like it where there's a little like 5 o'clock shadow instead of it completely cue bald.
I agree.
Right.
I don't think you should shave the whole thing.
I don't either.
Okay, I'll leave it. But I will leave it.
I do like the facial hair that you usually have though.
Right, then that went away last night because...
You made a mistake.
No, I went to get I got a haircut and a shave, and then I just tried to fix what he did, and it didn't work out, and I messed it. Yeah, I messed
it up. I've
done that. I messed it up because I'm just not in a happy place in terms of where I'm living. I liked living in the valley. I liked having, you know, my own room. Now I don't have these things. The place smells...
You have your own place.
Well... I don't know. It's just like the air mattress being on that. And I have a nice air mattress, too. I bought the heavy-duty one. But I should be on a regular mattress.
Why don't you just get a queen bed? Aren't they pretty cheap?
It's my twin was like, they're like three or four. They're like three now.
I don't know. I'm just trying to, you know, just doing... I'm living a very, what's it called, lifestyle? Very...
Simple?
No, there's a word for it.
Conservative?
Romantic?
No, very... it starts with an M.
Mommy?
Modest.
Not modest. I'm living a very... We'll come back to that. But that's my lifestyle.
Mommy.
Very simple. It's very... Maybe it starts
too.
With a B. Very bare bones.
Okay.
No.
Somebody modest.
Help me. Not modest. Modest is not the word.
Maple syrup.
No. I'm going to find out. Things are going great. Esther, you got...
Your place smells?
No, the hallways.
The hallways smell a little.
The hallways can have, but not in a horrible way. It just smells like somebody's, you know, the carpet and stuff. I'm very, very living a very partisan style.
Peasant?
Somebody, no, not peasant.
Amish.
No. So Esther, positive energy.
Yes.
Are you walking? Are you exercising? I saw you driving your car. That means you weren't walking.
I don't walk in general.
I got a Spartan lifestyle. Thank you. Got it. When
Spartan.
You people at home didn't think I had it, I do. My mother was born in Michigan, the state Spartan, Michigan State Spartans.
Spartan lifestyle.
Never
heard
look
of
it up.
That.
Look it up. Can you look it up, Brian?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank
you.
I don't walk. I do like weights in my bathroom.
In your bathroom?
I love the mirror in our bathroom.
It's a big one, right?
Yeah.
But that mirror does not, it's too far away. The counter's too big and... It's hard for me to get the mirror angle I need for shaving. And that's where I messed up my beard last night.
Oh, I put a separate mirror, too. I have an extra mirror in there as well.
Oh, yeah. You
on
know,
the other wall.
Hey, you should just go thrifting. Like that couch right there. I mean, it's like almost a brand new leather couch I got for $130. And that is the most comfortable
thrifting?
Couch.
Are you a 70-year-old grandma?
What's it called?
Garage sales?
Going to thrift stores.
Thrifting. Oh, go to thrift stores.
It's
okay.
Not called anything.
I call it thrifting.
Is yeah, I know. I've heard that term before. Esther.
Hey, that's negative.
Esther, stop being negative.
I'm out of control.
You've been out of control today.
Have you been smoking weed lately? Is this the birth control withdrawals that you're getting?
No, I'm just out of control.
So are you looking up Spartan Lifestyle?
Yeah.
I'm not claiming to be a smart guy.
This is what I've come across. The power, like Spartan Lifestyle. Why am I living?
No, just find the definition.
He's joshing us. Stop joshing us, Brian.
I'll look for it. I have it right here.
Sparta.
I'm Spartan Lifestyle.
Are we live on Ustream or no?
Yeah.
Oh. Do we have any viewers?
No. I put it in Spartan Lifestyle. But I want to get beyond that. And then once I get to a certain place where I need to be, then I'll be more open to dating and going out and being that man the woman needs. I'm working on a lot of things. I need to journal. I need to write jokes. I need to audition. I have some opportunities in January. I need to put together a demo tape. I need to get a new 8x10. I need to take an acting class. I need to drive down to the desert and see my mom every 3 weeks. I like seeing my mom, making up for lost time because I went away to play college baseball. I lived in New York for 3 years. I lived in Seattle for 3 years. So I left my mom and I owe it to her and to myself to come back and spend time down there. She likes it. I see Daisy. And if I can incorporate those two into my career, I will, whether they like it or not. I can't get internet connection in here. But that's what you got to do. It's like I got a lot of things, and I know a lot of people take Lexapro, so I don't have a problem talking about it.
I met a girl, a hot chick kind of girl, and her purse she put it on the table, and there was four prescription pill bottles sticking out, and I was like, what are those?
And you asked her?
Yeah, I did, and she was,
Esther asked her?
Yeah, and she said one was Lexapro, one was Xanax.
See, I don't take Xanax. What's this up there?
My favorite dog.
Oh, look at Daisy.
Oh, it's
Daisy. I love Daisy.
This is a recent one, I think.
I think Daisy and Pepper are long road distance.
Daisy's got to lose a couple pounds, I think. My mom hasn't been walking her enough. They're just like doing one lap. They go downstairs. They need to do a little more, I think. There she is, right there.
Is there a restroom nearby?
Yeah, there's a bucket right behind you.
Look at Daisy.
Alpina bucket.
What a good girl.
Is there, Brian?
Yeah, right in there in the next room.
The next room?
Yeah.
I'll be right back.
Yeah, so Esther's going to go to the restroom. I'm feeling like things are going well. I look forward to the podcast. I come in, and a lot of it's just talking. Eventually, maybe we'll be able to take phone calls. I was here for that Late Night Chronicles. That was great. A lot of positive feedback. Nobody says there's, you know, doing a podcast. This is kind of what I like, me, Brody. I like doing a podcast almost about doing a podcast. My podcast is about that. That's kind of what I want to do. I don't want to say I'm doing meta. Is that what they call it these days? But, yeah, maybe I am. Some people said I did meta comedy. I've heard that thrown around. I thought, you know, that's Ron Artest's new name, Meta World Peace. And I have heard the term, he's doing meta comedy, so I get it. But to be doing a meta podcast now we're on to something, because the podcasts are relatively new and there isn't that many. You can only probably name 20, and you work in the business.
Right.
You know, maybe 15 to 20 other podcasters. Right.
There's a lot of them, but there's a lot of them that aren't, you know, like people do like 5 episodes and they stop doing it. It's the hardest part is to continue to do them, I think.
But continuing to do them, you have that fire, you know, right, to get up out of your, well, people do them in their house. But, you know, I drove out here to Pasadena. I'll come out here all the time. You have to see if you have that fire. When I wanted to do stand-up comedy, or I said, I'm going to give it a shot right after graduating college and taking an acting class in college. People said, Brody, you should try comedy. So when I went to UCLA for this workshop, yes, I took a workshop on comedy because I come from that support system. I like having a group around. Mm-hmm. And I had to see if I had that fire to do comedy every week. And you know what? Driving from the Ventura Freeway to the 405 to Westwood, yes, I was excited. I liked doing it. And we'd had a 12-week course or whatever it was, and that's proved to me that I had it in me. And it's just like this podcast. It's the same kind of feeling. Even though I'm slurring my speech today, but that's because caffeine and the med. So whatever. If you think I'm slurring my speech today, I probably am. But don't hold that against me. I'm on a lot of stuff.
I'm back.
But I'm saying, Esther is back. But I'm saying the reason why I think this podcast, it's here to stay, it's the same feeling I had when I was doing stand-up comedy. So I'm going to push it. I'm going to do it for free. I'm not going to stop doing it because I get good feedback and it's therapeutic for me. And I could tell from people on Twitter and Facebook or whatever. And I did the Joe Rogan show and a third of the crowd knew me. There's something here. So what do you think?
Before I forget, I just want to ask all the listeners if they could please tweet at me what they get at Subway. I'm very curious.
Good question.
What I always go for whatever the $5 month of the thing is.
I try to do that.
I want everyone who eats at Subway to tweet at me exactly what they get on their sandwich.
I usually get tuna, but they have too much mayo in that. Yeah. Or yeah. I will get roast beef and turkey, something of that nature.
I like when tuna is made with mustard instead of mayo. Have you ever had that? Where you replace mustard?
Well, I've actually had mustard like on the bread with tuna. I've done that. I used to think that was like insane, but I've done it a couple times and it isn't that bad.
Yeah.
I went to Subway with my friend the other day and he pointed out to me, yes, I have one friend, that the meats are all turkey based. Like even the ham is a turkey based meat.
Is that good or bad?
I don't know.
Meaning it's like 75%.
Surprise, something like that.
Yeah.
That's weird.
I was also thinking, you're talking about friends. You said you had one friend. People don't call each other anymore. I don't think it's just me. I think people have gone into this isolationism and I feel like they're freaking out about what's going to happen in 2012. Like they think this is the end of the world. And these kids have been duped through these video games and TV shows and all that stuff. And I think they're saying, F it. I'm just going to be selfish because I don't get that many phone calls. Yeah. I call people. They don't call me back.
I don't even listen to my voicemail anymore.
That's douchey. You have an iPhone. Like, it's so easy to listen to voicemails.
But I have unheard voicemails to the point because I just don't like it anymore. I'd rather you text me the meat of what you called about instead of me having to like listen to a 2-minute conversation.
I used to be like that, and now I'm like, no, don't text me. Let's talk on the phone. Let's be
adults. That's why you always answer your phone, I see.
I always answer my phone. Oh, one time I didn't.
That's the vibe out there. I'm not saying that. I mean, texts are good. You know, getting a text, it is quick and to the point. But the phone call I guess people do hang out. I see it somewhere. I mean, when you're in show business or work in that world, it is kind of different. So I guess I was down in Hermosa Beach the other night and saw people hanging out. It was fun.
You did the Joe Rogan show, right, at the Comedy Magic Club?
Yeah, we did Hermosa Beach Comedy Magic Club. I've done that a handful of times, and Mike down there, the owner, guy who runs it. So nice. They give you free food. They take care of the comedians. Jay Leno is there every Sunday night, and I feel like I should take – they've opened their arms up to me on several different occasions, and I didn't reciprocate, meaning like, you know what, I could probably do more shows down here. So
I've never been invited there.
Well, you got to go with somebody. You mean invited by who?
Anybody.
You mean like going with a comic or something?
Yeah, I've never been there at all.
They would like you there just because they're a very like cleaner club, I guess.
Yeah, but you got to be clean. You to be clean.
Yeah. But you would be good there, I think.
I'm starting to get a little less clean, but.
Really?
I have one bit that, yeah.
You're growing.
I'm growing.
You know where I got being the clean? It was just like, I don't know. I was always just like from not cursing in front of my father. I was afraid to. I was never going to curse in front of my dad. My mom once in a while. But just I think it came from not cursing in front of my father, which again is a common theme, I'm sure. And then when I went up to Seattle, I met my friend Tana Manu, who doesn't talk to me anymore. And Tana, he won't return my phone call or text. He's mad at me because he's a guy who I probably lashed out when I was in my 6-day bender off Lexapro, people putting pressure on me. I never had a gun, never thought about hurting myself or anybody. I have to repeat that. Please, please take this to heart. I never had a gun or wanted to hurt myself or anybody. I was doing comedy on Twitter, hosting TMZ, performance art.
That's what Rogan called it.
It was.
Yeah.
But it was like...
No apologies.
Well, yeah, no apologies. Fuck everybody.
We both said the F word in this podcast.
You guys,
what's going
are
on?
Really,
you can curse
potty mouths.
It's because today. We haven't been here. It's because we've had too much time off in between podcasts, so we like are off.
But I'm not going to let people's going nervous crazy. Energy mess with me this time. I have to do. You know, it's like I pride myself. I did 2,000 audience warm ups. You know, when I was 400 warm ups at Chelsea, I felt I had a right to speak my mind, and I didn't. I did not have that right. I did not have any kind of leverage. The producer, the higher up, stepped to me in a physical manner. Okay, but, and I did the warm up. I warmed the crowd up, and then I kind of just tucked in and let the show play, and it didn't play well, and I got hit with another wave, and I just felt I was going to get fired. I was afraid of Chelsea. I didn't want to be in that situation. I gave my heart to the show, loyal worker, and I felt like, yeah, maybe I could have. I was growing out of the position, possibly, I don't know, but for it to end like that hard, I didn't want it to. I thought it would be nice if I could train somebody and switch off, but maybe Chelsea didn't want them. Maybe she wanted a full-time guy. Bottom line is, I didn't like how it ended, but a lot of jobs are that way.
Yeah.
You know, they end bad.
They do.
Why is that? Why? Tell us.
Because if it wasn't bad, it wouldn't end, you know?
Well, sometimes you know you need to move on. You have to move to another part of the country. That ends. That's not bad.
Yeah.
You have a family. Your wife gives birth, or you have to give birth, and you move on.
Mm-hmm.
That's not bad. I mean, a job ending is not always bad, but a lot of them do end bad.
Yeah.
And I'm saying I've been around. That was a job that ended bad, and it bothers me. And it I don't. I feel I'm not angry. There's no anger. But it just bothers me.
That's okay. That's normal.
Well, how do we get through it?
You just time. I always say, because I've gone through some tough breakups, that time heals all wounds.
How much for being feeling like you're being forced out or going to get fired, so you quit? How long for that?
They usually say half of how long you were there.
Oh,
so
really?
if your relationship was 2 years, it could take up to a year to get over it fully.
I was there about 3 years.
And it's really important to express the emotions you have about it and to feel them and not to hide them and like stuff them down, because then it's just going to hit
you. I had a good time. That was my thing. I had a ritual. So, I worked out. I ate. I went to Subway like we're talking. I made positive energy. And then I would drive there, stretch, do my yoga in the sun, and then do the show. Once in a while, I got in trouble. It was all show related. It wasn't like coming to work drunk, coming to work high, coming to work and being inappropriate.
I think you're hurt, and you know, you don't like how it ended, and so there's like this uncertainty, and you're just hurt because you missed that structure that you once had.
That? I'm hurt? Yes, I'm hurt. From not having that structure, I enjoyed
but
working.
It's like any other relationship. Like, you're really upset over the one that just ended, but then as soon as like you're gonna suffer for a while through that, and then once
16 months,
once the new one comes and it's way better, you're not gonna be upset about losing that one.
Yeah, I mean, people. That's what I was saying. Like, a lot of people said, Brody, you don't need to be doing warm up anymore. You're bigger than warm up. And I felt that. I felt that I was growing out of it.
Yeah.
In some way or fashion. But I felt like to have it just clipped, stopped. And obviously I was hurt because I went in there and I quit. And, you know, they go, hey, Brody, you know, they say, okay, bye. It was like very passive. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, then that's hurtful because you were invested in this relationship. And they, like, you don't feel like they were as invested as you were. They didn't care about
you
as much as you cared
about
them.
It ended bad. It ended bad. And I've been around Arizona State Baseball for 20 years. I've been around Fox Sports for 6 to 7 years. I've lived in New York City. I've had several dinners with Joe Torre. I respect of one of the top five comedic actors in Hollywood, Zach Galifianakis. I've been flown to Bangkok for Hangover 2. I kind of know how to hang out with guys like Bradley Cooper, people's most sexiest person on earth. Yeah. I'm in this world, so I kind of know how to act and what's up. I'm not some like...
Yeah, no, everyone knows that.
I just came into town today.
And they didn't treat you like that. They treated you like you were just like whatever there.
Well, I didn't expect them to treat me like that. I'm saying because I lived like that or living like that, I know how people are. That I'm around the top of the top. So I see top of the top mannerisms, top of the top class, top of the top communication, top of the top good people. That's what I get to see. So when somebody's not doing that, and instinctively I feel in my chest, that's not right, and I look at them, I go, well, that's not cool. Because I know I'm putting out positive energy. You know?
I see.
So you just voted for, you think Ryan Gosling's better looking than Bradley Cooper?
I voted for Bradley.
I have a tie. I used to be in love with Bradley Cooper, but now I think maybe Ryan Gosling.
Bradley's a great guy. Good guy.
I watched Due Date and I loved it.
It's good, isn't it? I thought it was a nice, fun movie.
It's so cool that you're in
that
movie.
You know, Zach is what I'm just so surprised about. Zach has turned into one of those characters that I could watch him almost in anything. You know,
he's so funny.
He's like becoming like a Will Ferrell. Will Ferrell's the same. I could watch almost Will Ferrell in anything.
So. I loved Due Date. And I emailed my mom that it was on HBO so she could watch your stuff.
Yeah, I probably have some residual checks.
She thought it was really cool.
Yeah, do you get checks from that a lot? Or
yes.
Pretty decent?
Not a lot. No, I don't. Once in a while I get checks, and once in a while they're worth something. I'll say that. But for the most part, you know, I was a bit player. I'm just, you know.
Esther, has your show
more than
appearance?
A bit player. I'm more than a bit
aired
player.
Here?
No, none of my stuff is aired yet. My commercial is going to be soon, and my New Girl episode is December 6th.
December 6th.
Oh, that's coming up.
Yes.
December 6th. And what do you? Can you tell us what you play in that?
I play a 16-year-old who, Zoe, like, that's like me and two other girls, and we're like inner-city teens, and Zoe, like, tries to help us out.
Do you have interaction with Zoe? Do you exchange lines with her?
Yeah, all my scenes are with Zoe.
Were you nervous or were you prepared and just did it?
I was very, very nervous. Not about being around Zoe, but just like being on a set. I was really nervous the first day. Like I was like just like nervous I was going to miss lines because I'm really scared of lines.
But did you have your lines memorized?
Yeah, well, it's hard because every morning, like I memorized everything over the weekend because I found out I got the part on Friday and we started on Monday.
Uh-huh.
And actually I found out I got it on Saturday. And I memorized everything, and then as soon as you get there, everything's changed. All the lines in the script are changed.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Yeah, so it's like every morning I had to like deal with that. But yeah, I mean, it's not like I had a ton of lines, so it's not a big deal, but yeah, there was like some ones that like I would kind of mess up sometimes because they were confusing.
And were there a lot of people on set when they said action?
Yeah, there was a lot of it's single camera, so it's like shooting a movie, I think.
Right.
Similar.
So
it's on a soundstage.
But did you feel pressure on you when it was your line?
Yeah, I was really scared. I got super comfortable towards the end, and
right.
Like it was fun. But the first day, like I can't even imagine. Like I can't. I would not want to go back to that because I was like terrified.
But once you're over that, you're ready to come back. Like, I can do this.
Yeah. Then it started to get really fun. It was very fun.
That's the hard part, getting in. You know, I was able to do that on The Hangover. I walked in front of 200 people, mostly extras. And I had to walk in there like 8 in the morning on a Monday or Tuesday or whatever it was. And, you know, knock out my line, knock out my part. And I'm actually more prepared now. You learn from it. That's the first time. It's like, you know what? I'm kind of flat-footed. Boom. And then the second day, I brought that energy for the taser scene in a nonverbal way. And we all know what happened with that. That's, you know, it's a classic scene. And I pushed the energy. And I did some nonverbal work in there based off the day before because I was confident, comfortable. And then when I did Due Date, I was comfortable and confident because I've done it before. And I'm driving the car, and I'm with Robert Downey Jr., and it's 2 days. Like, and I had to do, they're pulling me, and then I'm driving, hitting my spot. And
what was Robert Downey like?
Nice guy. He was, you know, we talked about, we didn't talk about acting, but we kind of were in character here and there. We talked about L.A. and the Valley and Santa Monica. and just small talk, but organic food. He actually gave me some organic oatmeal. He's very into health. He's very into having a personal chef. A lot of those guys do. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They have personal chefs where they make a specific diet. But he was very open to talking about vitamins, going, taking me to a place in Santa Monica and getting tested and getting the right vitamins for me. Wow. So nothing but positive, nothing but support. We do it, and he was never a jerk, like, come on, or like, never that.
Yeah.
Very
Zoe, yes.
Laid back.
Same with, after we finished, I like had the biggest crush on Zoe Deschanel for like a long, like I was just not like a, like.
Did lesbian. You cause her divorce?
I was just like obsessed with her and like downloaded all her music because she has like two albums. She was so nice and like. Just,
are her songs pretty serious, like real songs?
Yeah. Her music career is like pretty big. She's a real musician and is very talented.
What instrument does she play? Drums?
I don't even know. I think.
What's her name again? Zoe what?
Zoe Deschanel. Deschanel.
I mean, she's in a lot of big movies.
She's a great singer. D-E-S-C.
I think if you just type in Zoe D, it'd pop up.
Yeah, I would, actually. It's Z-O-O-E-Y.
Did she make eye contact and all that stuff with you?
Oh, yeah. We talked like a lot, actually.
Really?
Yeah. She was really nice and cool and made it very clear, like, that because it was me and three other people that were the guests on that episode, and she made it like very clear that we were their guests.
How would she think about me with my hair?
She would like it.
It's not weird.
No, she's really nice.
How come I think it's weird?
Because you're used to seeing yourself this a certain way, and you're not used to this different way.
And so what?
And we're also really critical on ourselves.
What about my close friends? Will they notice?
Doubtful.
But you're saying it's not even weird. It's nothing abnormal. It's like having a mustache or not.
Yeah.
I just happen to be shaving my hairline back. Is that her?
Yeah.
It's so easy to fall in love. It's so easy. Tell
me love. I love her.
How old is she? 30 now?
Something like that, yeah. It seems
so easy. So easy.
So easy. Yeah.
Oh, she's beautiful. So easy. Zoe, you're so easy to fall in love. Not that way. Not that way. Not that way. You can edit that out. I didn't mean that. You know that. It's so... That's a Joan... That's the girl. See, these meds hurt my memory. That's the girl, the country singer.
Mm-hmm.
What's a country singer that sings a song?
That's Zoe singing.
No, but just it's a cover.
It's a cover.
It's a cover of...
It's so...
Judith Earth.
I love Zoe.
Okay, but you should know who sings this song. June.
I love Zoe. It's so easy to fall in love.
Yeah, but here's the deal.
Dolly
listen,
Parton.
Esther, listen to me.
Dolly Parton?
No, because the next time you see Zoe, you could talk about this to say, oh, that's the cover for who sang this song.
Oh, I wouldn't.
Well, why not?
I'm shy.
But Esther, that's how you get movies. You know the little things like that. I'm looking it up right now. It's so easy to fall up. I'm saying I don't know because I'm on meds.
And I don't know because I'm not a country folk music.
I'm typing it in.
I don't know these songs. Play.
This is her top hit. It's called A Very Important Thing to Do from Winnie the Pooh.
Play Sentimental Heart.
I don't know.
How do you spell fall?
F-A-L.
It's so easy to...
You're a firecracker today.
I'm not.
Like, have you started smoking marijuana
no,
or something?
No, I'm just really alone.
Are you dating somebody right now?
I'm not. Yesterday I was really alone, and so I...
You were when I approached you in your car.
Yes.
It's so easy to fall. No, but guys, I guess, okay, you want to go against Brody's instincts.
No,
I'm telling you that I think we should find out who sings
it's
the regular
so
song.
Easy to I can't,
it starts
fall
with a J.
Love.
It's June or Jude.
It's Jude Apatow.
No. Brian, you have quick internet up there?
Yeah.
Jude Apatow.
Can you type, find out who sang the song for me? I'm going to have a mental
Judas,
effect.
Judah.
But I'm only...
Linda Ronstadt?
No.
Well, Judas Apatow.
Does it say that? It
yeah.
might be.
Yeah, it is. Linda Ronstadt. It's right. So easy to...
Good
what
good
if
enough.
What if Judd was, Apatow betrayed someone and then that person called him Judas Apatow? Did anyone hear me out there?
What song is this?
It's so easy to fall in love.
Linda Ronstadt.
It's so easy to fall
yep,
in love.
Thank you. Brian. I was wrong. I make mistakes.
You're human.
But I was acting all pushy. But we got it. We got the answer. Esther, why don't you dance on camera?
Yeah, dance. Use that light, that lamp behind you as a pole.
That's sick. It's so easy.
Are we getting any Twitter responses? Let me see.
It's so easy.
Probably not.
So easy to fall in love. You guys, I'm a musician.
So
Brody, could we be in a band together?
I need to take drum lessons. If anybody out there...
Oh, you're
there,
a drummer. I forgot you're a musician.
I have drum rhythm, but I need...
Wait a second. Brody and I used to be a part of the same band, just at different times.
Different times. Powerful, positive new look. Your head looks cold, though. No, I'm not cold.
Oh, there's people listening?
Maybe a couple people.
It's so easy.
No, I have rhythm. I have chops somewhat, but I need lessons to make it official. It's like I'm a good pitcher. I throw the ball well, but my mechanics aren't ideal, and I'm going to get hurt. Or I'm not going to be able to command the pitches. Mm-hmm. I might throw hard, but... So I need some mechanical coaching for drums.
I want to get that new... I don't know if you've seen it. It's like Guitar Hero. It's like a video game, but you can use a real guitar. Have you seen that?
No.
It's called Rocksmith. And here, I'll show you a preview of it. But it's pretty sweet. It's like a good way to learn how to play guitar, but using a video game.
I like it.
It's so easy.
I'm not against it.
It's so easy to play guitar.
No, it's not. That's cool.
So, yeah, I don't know if it comes with a guitar or if you just plug in your own guitar. I think you just plug in your own,
I bet you.
I have to go pretty soon.
All right.
It's a great design. It's often.
Hey, there I am.
Brody.
This guy shaved his whole head.
Yeah, he can do it. You're doing well. So, yeah, it's kind of like you... It detects what notes you play, and then you get points, like if you play the right notes, and it's like a game that teaches you how to play guitar.
I have no idea how to play guitar. Like, I have no...
Do I have small hands. I can't
Me
do
too.
It. Yeah, I know.
I think being able to play guitar is a cool thing.
Former hand model, American Girl doll catalog.
I tell you, a girl with small hands is one of the best.
I know you're getting it.
Yeah, we know. It's disgusting. We just squashed you.
Oh.
You're bad.
So Esther has to get going. I got to do a few things today. I got to return a couple emails. It's beautiful out here in Pasadena. I may stay.
I thought we were in a secret location.
Oh, I mean, this is in the shadows of people.
We're in a basement.
It's still secret. You could say
we're at the Pasadena Ice House Comedy Club.
Brian, no.
Brian, please.
Brian, stop.
Brian, don't. Brian. It's a crazy world. It's a crazy world when people say we have no jobs. We're in a 2012 situation. Yet that video game Call of Duty or whatever made like $400 million over
great?
The weekend.
I love
I
it.
Guess.
I love the fact that video games are now making more than movies.
Well, haven't they been making more than movies for a while?
Yeah.
I love the fact that some web shows get more views than TV shows.
Oh, they do. Give me
I
an
learned
example.
That yesterday.
Give me an example.
Yesterday I had a meeting at Yahoo and they told me that their entertainment news show gets like about like what cable shows
oh the
get
one like yeah. News in a Minute
OMG
the podcast I do with Joe Rogan gets more than most TV shows on cable.
Give me some like actual real. Do you know any actual shows
it's
it beats
so
out
easy
anything
to
on MTV
have
too
a successful podcast
really
yeah.
So what do you think it is? Do you think it's about ratings? Do you think it's about quality? Do you think
it's
about raising the bar of America?
I think web is more accessible.
It's accessibility. It's absolutely correct. I mean, you're getting people at work. Everyone has computers now wherever they go. Everyone at work has computers.
Not everyone has a computer. I'm kidding.
But isn't there still prestige about the TV show?
Yes, I think so. But I wonder if that's just because I'm excited that I was on one.
Right.
So it might just be
biased. What about movies? Like, what is that? What about the prestige? Isn't movies the top thing?
I hardly go to movies
anymore. Movies are the top
thing. Hardly go to watch
most
TV
respected?
Anymore.
Yes, for sure.
So you're saying
podcasts are not more respected than movies, everyone.
but
it's so easy.
You would say movies is the top of the game.
Absolutely.
Being a movie star.
For sure. No doubt about it.
Than a rock star.
Look at Kim Kardashian. She's super famous, but she just secretly wants to be a movie star.
She does?
Yeah. She's trying to be in that Tyler Perry movie, and there's a web campaign to get her out of it because America hates her now because she lied.
She lied about what? Saying that the wedding, it was real love?
Well, we feel like, because me personally, I watched the wedding special.
You were invested.
You know, and I was like, wow, they're so happy, and I got jealous. And then now they're divorced, and I'm not happy about it.
Are you happy that she was not up front? You know, or this was not real? It was made for TV? Just, it was rushed?
It's just she's...
She's not owning it?
She's not owning it, and it's like, it was all fake. It was for a wedding special. She got married to have a wedding special on E!
Isn't Bruce Jenner funny with the both earrings? And I can't stop laughing at him.
He's funny.
He's a good guy on that show for the most part, right? He's the voice of reason.
Yeah, he's good, yeah.
I mean, you know that he was in the Olympics, right?
Yeah.
He was in the Wheaties box.
He's like the future of, who's the big Olympic guy that we love? That did the
swimming guy.
Michael Phelps.
Yeah, but they're different things.
He's cute.
Bruce Kardashian was great when he won the 19th. Bruce Kardashian. You know his name? He took his wife's name. I enjoy podcasting. I feel like I can do this almost every day. I have connections of everyone. I can get baseball players when that's going to be in season. I'll be doing that. I can get Bradley Cooper. We're going to have a lot of fun. Brody Stevens. Yes. Esther, she has to get going. She has an audition, I believe, right? Or a meeting?
No, I just have.
You got to get going.
I have.
You've had enough.
Oh, no. I have a babysitting.
Really?
Yeah.
Do they have any mail openings? Do the kids have any mail openings? I did shave. Hopefully I don't work. So Esther, you're saying tonight, don't just leave it how it is.
Yes.
And you'll check on me in the next couple days, my beard growth and all that?
Yes, I will check in. I like you with facial hair.
So do I. Why?
It's just I like facial hair on guys.
Okay,
think a lot of
Brody, have you ever just grown out your facial hair and not like trimmed it or anything? You know, kind of.
Yeah,
like
I was like that almost last week. I got to that point. I was at that point last week. Actually, yeah, like a couple days ago. So hopefully I won't have any issues with this in the future. Esther, you have great rhythm. You love Lady Gaga?
I love Lady Gaga.
Do you think she's better than Madonna? Different?
Different.
Do you think she's stolen Madonna's vibe and point of view?
Her essence.
I think there's influences.
Her good word, her essence. There's, her Spartan lifestyle.
No, there's influences.
I'm going to start working out some more. I have a spin bike. I walked for almost 1 hour last night on the streets of Hollywood. It was like Bruce Springsteen song, Streets of Philadelphia, but it was Streets of Hollywood. And I walked around.
Is this song? I'm sorry.
This is Baby Gaga.
No, but it's like a mix.
It's a mashup.
Are mashups still popular?
I like them.
Mashups are not.
It's like ADD cool. For me.
Where do you find them?
Just mashup. Just put in your favorite song and type in the word mashup at the end of it.
Brilliant. Drummer, because I know this because when I used to dance on stage at the Comedy Store and Brody would guest in, he was a really good.
I had good rhythm for that.
It was really helped my dancing.
But I need lessons. I need drum lessons.
Well, yeah,
I'd like to get a website update. I would like my Wikipedia page to be grown. I haven't gone on there, but I hear I have one.
Get a Wikipedia page.
All things Brody on Twitter. All things Brody on Twitter. I've done a lot of tweeting. I don't know. Maybe I'm doing it wrong. Maybe I need to tweet less. But I feel like the podcast and what I'm doing right now, these words that I am saying right now are more powerful. They have a greater reach than one of the 140.
Brian.
Esther, I was in the middle of a great speech. This is powerful stuff. And I think you burping into a mic.
Was Brian.
No, it was not.
But that's okay. Listen, I think we're going to wrap it up, right? We did pretty good today.
Yeah.
My name is Stephen Brody Stevens. You can see me in February at the Vancouver Comedy Festival. You can see me weekly around Los Angeles at various alternative B rooms. I get nervous sometimes at the Laugh Factory. I get nervous in a packed room at the Comedy Store. But put me in a banquet hall in the Valley, I hit my stride. Things are good for me. Esther, how are you doing?
I'm good. I am at the Comedy Store tonight and then the Ice House and then probably nowhere for a while because I'm going to go home and go to sleep.
You're going to go home to Illinois?
No, I'm going to go home to my apartment.
Your apartment's clean?
It's very clean.
Your mom cleaned it?
Yeah, it's super clean now.
My apartment needs to be clean. Did she teach you anything? Like maybe you could help me.
Maybe, but...
Pass it on. Pass on the sponge. Ryan Redband, any final words for today on the Death Squad Network?
Nope. We have a show tonight with Joe Rogan and Doug Benson here at the Ice House. And tomorrow we have another Death Squad show that we have a bunch of the whole Bone Zone crew is going to be doing it.
Oh, Yusuf, great.
And Brendan Walsh and Davey and all those guys.
What night are they going to be in? Saturday?
No, they're going to be here Friday night at 10 p.m. at the Ice House. And then tonight is Joe Rogan at 10 p.m.
When's Doug Benson?
Doug Benson's going to be here tonight at 10 p.m.
Oh, tonight?
I might come hang out tomorrow. I'm performing tonight.
Well, yeah, definitely. You can be on the show tomorrow.
Let's just take over the podcast world.
Let's do it.
Storm.
But go to icehousecomedy.com for all the information.
And all things Brody podcast on Twitter. It's the hottest Twitter profile, blowing up daily, adding up to 3 followers per day. Maybe you can be the next one.
All right. See you guys.
I got electronic beats. I got hip hop music. What the future flow? So come on, red. Even if the sky.